Now, I know the title of this video said when the crosstalk failed, and you actually see pass in the top right hand corner here, but you'll see it's got an asterisk next to it, which means it's a marginal pass. Now, on this occasion, even though the standard says a pass is a pass, the client rejected the test results. He actually specified no marginal passes. And why? Because he's paying for a premium cabling system. And if you have a premium cabling system, you shouldn't see marginal passes. If you purchase one of these minimally compliant cabling systems, then you can expect to see these marginal passes. So crosstalk is marginal within the accuracy of the instrument. Let's tap on next. And we'll tap here. And that will take us to the worst performing pair for near end crosstalk. In this case, in the top left hand corner, we can see is pair 1, 2, 3, 6. Now, there's not much information to be gathered from this screen apart from the fact that it's pair 1, 2, 3, 6, which has got the most significant amount of crosstalk on it. Now, wouldn't it be nice if we could look down the cable and see where the crosstalk is happening? And that's exactly what you can do with the DSX cable analyzer. If I go back to this screen here and tap on the diagnostic, I got two time domain diagnostic options. That's the ability to look down the cable. The first one is my high definition time domain reflectometer, or I like to say return loss. It's a good way of remembering that that's for return loss. It allows you to look for impedance anomalies. Well, we don't have a return loss issue. Then we have our high definition time domain crosstalk. Now, we do have a crosstalk issue. So let's tap on there. And let's go and look at our troublesome pair, which is our 1, 2, 3, 6. I'm going to tap on here until I see 1, 2, 3, 6 in the top left hand corner. So now we're actually looking down the cable here. And the general rule of thumb is that in the cable, I don't want to see more than 10% as an event. And if I do, I don't really want to see more than 4 or 5 of them. Now, clearly that is not the case here. Let me magically put in the 10% line here now. And as you can see, most of the cable is above the 10% line. It's not always as obvious as this. Sometimes it can be a little bit subtle, but on this occasion, clearly demonstrated, we have a cable issue, the worst thing that you want. I mean, everybody's okay with re-terminating connector. On this one, not a good situation. The cable had to be removed in order to get it to pass.